What's up? I'm RJ Bukulo, filmmaker, comic book creator, and mental health ambassador, here to help empower you to tell better visual stories with the best filmmaking tips, tricks, and techniques. Footage shot in log is an intermediary state, meaning this is not meant to be its final form. Log footage needs work done, and it comes in two processes, color correcting and color grading. Color correcting involves restoring log footage to a more visually acceptable standard, meaning making the blacks look black and whites look white, and the rest of the colors as accurate and balanced from one clip to another. With most log footage, this can be easily done with a simple conversion or utility LUT, often provided by the camera manufacturers, or in this case, the app developers. Indeed, MC Pro 24fps does provide technical LUTs free to download on their website to use with their log settings. What these specific LUTs do is convert the footage to the standard Rec. 709 format. Once a conversion LUT is applied, minor tweaks can be done on individual clips so that the clips overall have a consistent look. Generally, in color correcting, the goal is to make the colors look close to real life as possible. Now I'm going to show you three different ways we can color correct log footage. The first and probably easiest way is to use a conversion LUT. First, let's download the free technical LUTs that MC Pro 24fps provides on their website. Once you've downloaded these, you can extract and copy these into the LUTs folder in your DaVinci Resolve directory or whatever video editor you're using. Once you've started up DaVinci Resolve and have your project open and footage laid out in the timeline, you can switch to the color grading workspace, which you can find on the bottom panel strip. Find our LUTs, let's open up the LUTs tab and go down the list until you find MC Pro 24fps technical LUTs. You'll notice there's quite a few options to choose from here, even though they serve the same purpose. In short, 1D cube LUTs are used for simple conversion of exposure and light values. 3D cube LUTs contain more information such as color channel values, while the number next to it designates how many points of detail are on it. The higher the number, the more processor hungry it is. And DCTL stands for DaVinci Color Space Transform Language, which is just another type of LUT made for DaVinci Resolve. Once you choose the appropriate folder, you can choose your LUTs according to the log gamma curve you used to shoot in with MC Pro 24fps. The technical LUTs they provide are for the HLG, MLOG, and MSLOG series of gamma curves. Once you select the matching gamma curve, you can choose to what color space you want to transform your log footage to. Gamma 2.2 and 2.4 are typical preview settings for log, while Rec. 709 and sRGB are standard color spaces for viewing and delivery. Using the Rec. 709 LUT should be fine. Just drag the LUT to the empty node on the right side. Applying the LUT should have restored the proper exposure and color saturation, although you may still need to do your own little tweaks here and there since not every clip is the same. Let's try it with the MSLOG curve. So MSLOG, Rec. 709, MSLOG 82%. It's this one. There we go. As you can see here, even though these clips were shot in different gamma curves in MC Pro 24fps, applying the appropriate technical LUT or conversion LUT, all the clips are now conformed to the same color correction. Now, if you're using one of the many famous camera brand log profiles in MC Pro 24fps, like Sony's S-Log2 or Arri Alexa's Log-C, then you can use the specific conversion LUTs made for those profiles, usually provided by their manufacturers. Or you can use the next method. Still in our color grading workspace in DaVinci Resolve, instead of applying a conversion LUT, we can pull from the effects panel what's called Color Space Transform. So what this does is convert a gamut, or color space, into another color space, which for our purposes is the standard Rec. 709. This can also be used if you want to conform your smartphone footage to match with the color space of footage from another camera, like a mirrorless or cinema camera. For input color space, choose the gamut and gamma curve you originally shot in with MC Pro 24fps. So this footage was shot with a C Cinema gamut from the Canon line. Canon Cinema Gamut, And the gamma curve used was the C-Log3. Canon C-Log3. There we go. And the output should be Rec 709, which is already automatic for me, as my timeline setting. So without transform, with transform. And voila, just like that, your footage has been delogged and corrected. Last one, let's try it here with Panasonic's log profile. So the gamut, input gamut is Panasonic V gamut, and the input gamma is Panasonic's V log. And there we go. Just like that. Your log footage is now corrected. I have to say, props to MC Pro 24fps developers for providing these really accurate gamut and gamma curve options. You can see side by side how conformed all these clips are now, even though they were shot in different log settings. The last method to color correct your smartphone log footage is to do it manually. It might not be the most ideal or efficient approach to correct your footage, especially if your project has a lot of clips, but I still believe it is a necessary experience to better understand your footage and how to get the best out of it. Also, if you just slap on a LUT or use color space transform, every clip or shot will always be exposed differently and have nuanced differences that will require some manual tweaking shot by shot to get it perfect. So a quick and simple way to do this is using curves and adding points to make a so-called S-curve. What this does is bump up the highlights and deepens the shadows while making the color channels richer too. Another way is to use the color wheels and simply bringing the lift down, which is for shadows, raising the gain, which is for highlights, and adjusting the gamma, which is for the mids. Use the waveform scopes on the right side to see your exposure range expand, making sure not to peak or blow out the highlights or blacks. Then you can pump in some of the saturation that was lost in the log capture, and of course use the temperature and tint settings to manually white balance your footage. The next stage in the color workflow, which is the fun part for most people, is creating a look or mood by creatively playing with the different color modifiers and curves. Color grading is pretty much subjective. You can make it as stylized as you want, or have a more subtle color grade that gives it a filmic cinematic look. Just do keep in mind, smartphone footage, even if shot in log, is still pretty limited when it comes to how aggressive you push or tweak the colors. So a good rule of thumb is to make small incremental adjustments and just gently massage the footage so that the image doesn't fall apart with artifacts, noise, or banding. Now for this exercise, let us try out three popular color grading looks and look at the steps of how to get them. Usually it's a good practice to apply these settings on an adjustment layer above your footage, which is also convenient for color correcting, not just one clip, but all your clips, as long as the adjustment layer covers it. So the first look that we're going to attempt is called the high key look, or a vibrant look. Now this is great for lighthearted or inspirational films, or even comedic films, anything that you want to be more positive and happier. So we already have our conversion LUT applied. Let's add a new serial node before our conversion LUT. Doing it before the conversion LUT ensures that the final output will still be conformed to the Rec 709 format. And so we do everything before that LUT. So we're here again in the primaries of the color wheels, and we're going to play around with the lift and the gain to make those shadows a bit more pronounced, just a little bit. And then the gain, we're going to take it up really high to make it really bright. Not too bright. We're always looking at our scopes here to make sure nothing gets overblown. It's good. Then we could also play around with the gamma. Increase that so that our midtones get brighter. That the overall feeling is bright. To make it even more sunny feeling, I'm gonna add a little warmth to the color in the midtones. So I'll just drag this towards the yellow-orange. Right, just a little bit to give it that summer vibe. Without, with. See, already quite a difference there. tweaking a little bit more. Let's increase the saturation to make the colors really pop. So the blue in the water, the green in the leaves. So you can use saturation. You can also use color boost. Just to keep in mind, these effects can get really strong, so just be ever so gentle with them. So you can see here that the leaves look more lush and the pinks are more vibrant. Again, with big difference. Let's just boost the highlights just a little bit to make it extra bright, like it's a really sunny day, even though the day was overcast when I shot it. And we can even tweak the contrast to make it even more poppier. Look at that, look at the blue water. So again, without as it was, just with the conversion LUT, and with our color grade, the high key vibrant look. So the next look that we're gonna go for is a cross process look, or the vintage look. And actually we're just gonna build upon the last look that we were worked on. So we still have our nodes there. Let's add a third node right after our high key look and right before our conversion LUT. And then from here, now this is really simple. Let's go to our curves, set up color wheels, and then just turn on the red channel and drag the highlights up, and then let's bring down the shadows on the red channel. Now let's go to the blue channel and we're gonna do the opposite. I'm gonna bring down the highlights and raise the shadows. Now within seconds we just achieved that kind of cross-processed film look or vintage look. Let's turn off that node and see what it looks like. Just in the regular vibrant mode and then with the cross-process look. So essentially what we did is made the highlights more warmer and the shadows more cooler or bluer. And to really sell this look, we can go back to our editing timeline and add film grain in our filters. We can add film grain to really give it that old film look. And I'm gonna take it one step even further by adding an 8mm film overlay to make it look like it really was shot on a film camera, even though this was all on a smartphone. And voila, cross-process vintage look. Now this is a great look for like travel videos or just if you wanna capture some summer vibes and you're vlogging. Now the last look that we're gonna try and attempt is called the low-key look or the moody look. Now this would be great for a Hollywood thriller or a dystopian sci-fi look. So once again, let's add a new node before our conversion. Now this is the opposite of the vibrant look. So instead of raising up the gain and the gamma, we're gonna actually bring it down. And you'll notice just by bringing the midtones, highlights and shadows remain the same, but the overall look seems more darker. And then we're gonna add a tint even on that, on the midtones here. So we're gonna grab the dot here in the gamma and shift it to the blues or blue greens to really give it that kind of sci-fi look that you see like in, I don't know, with the Matrix, Blade Runner. There you can see already. Looks like a really ominous day. So without, with. Let's also bring down the highlights over here. And then let's increase the contrast to make it even more harsher, like the harsh realities of the future that we're living in. Or here I might bring down saturation too, because the blue of the swimming pool is looking too bright. There you go. It's like something's gonna happen here. This is what it looks like with our adjustments, our moody look, and without. Looks like something's really gonna go down here at this resort. Lastly, if you want to really sell this Hollywood look, why not add some anamorphic bars and give it that really Hollywood widescreen look. And there you go. Three simple color grading looks. A high key vibrant look. The cross process vintage look. And the low key moody look. Thank you.
I still need to recover from another lover. Would you be here for me? Never met your parents, not even your mother. But let's see where this leads. What should we do tonight? What if this breaks your little heart?
Going on a journey, going on an adventure, seeing what the world has to